Here you go. Ready?
Colonel G.I. Wilson and his daughter, Kendra, love to play with their dogs in the backyard. Wilson, who is 64 and has now retired from the Marine Corps, deployed numerous times. But after his last deployment to Iraq in 2005, Kendra noticed he was changed.
His last tour over there, when he came back, that was the first time that I ever actually noticed a significant difference in his personality, the way he was acting, just even driving down the freeway, I was like, okay. Plus, there was the medical aspect of that was the first time I had ever been told that he had actually been hit by an IED and there was significant damage.
I thought everybody was reacting differently. You know, the dog reacted differently, and my daughter reacted differently, and my wife reacted differently. And I thought it was them. And of course, it was me, not them.
We would have a discussion, and 10 minutes later, he would ask me a question about what we had just discussed. I'm like, Dad, we just talked about that.
Wilson found he was having trouble processing information, remembering things, and finding words. His normally outgoing personality changed. He was withdrawn and depressed. When his dog died in 2009, that's 3 years after he came back from Iraq, it triggered a major breakdown.
I knew from his, from his rank and his past experience that he'd done very high-level work. He'd written long treatises or papers, and he was telling me he was having difficulty doing that kind of work, exactly the same kind of work after the blast injury.
Most people diagnosed with mild traumatic brain injury, or TBI, recover in a matter of months. Baker says there were no tests or brain scans to provide objective evidence of more lasting damage to the brain.
So you were just left a little in the dark, as was the patient. So I needed some help to find some kind of, have an objective measure of whether this had whether they had TBI.
And let me open up the door.
Enter Dr. Mingxiong Huang. Using a magnetoencephalographic, or MEG, brain scanner, one of only 20 in the country, Dr. Huang zeroes in on slow waves emitted by cells in the brain.
Keep your eyes closed for 5 minutes and open up for another 5 minutes. It's frustrating, and when the conventional neuroimaging do not provide and the location of injury and the network associated with the injury. So that actually motivate me in particular, develop new technology based on MEG slow wave measurements to make the invisible injury visible.
Normal MRI brain scans only pick up the symptoms of mild traumatic brain injury about 10% of the time, whereas this scanner, which is a MEG brain scanner, picks up those symptoms in the brain more like 90% of the time.
And there's something over here.
For the first time, Wilson had physical evidence that what he was experiencing had a physiological cause. Dr. Baker says the MEG brain scans may eventually be able to help her diagnose whether patients are suffering from symptoms of PTSD or TBI, which respond to different kinds of treatment.
One thing, it can track people who are getting different kinds of treatments and look at the resolution through objective scan evidence. So you can begin to more carefully compare the outcomes of treatments that might be brought in that are new treatments to help with mild TBI.
And for Wilson and his family, it was a huge relief to get a confirmation of his physical injury.
Even though we knew it in our minds and our hearts, it was kind of like the concrete that it's not us. Like, he's not reacting like this because he's mad at us or his feelings have changed in any way, shape, or form. Like, there's an actual physical cause that's making this happen. And that makes it a little easier to deal with.
I'm very, very fortunate because I can see it. They're able to demonstrate what happened to me, even though it basically is an invisible injury. You know, what about all those people that out there today that, you know, the soldiers, sailors, Marine, and airmen who have this injury, don't know it, no one's seen it. The research that the university has done with the VA is very, very important in getting to that problem. The invisible injury is not so invisible.
For Colonel Wilson, the MEG brain scans have made all the difference to his ability to recover and slowly learn how to get back to the life he wants to lead.